The last thing is, but how do we know it's a RET instruction? Remember, we need to make our prediction while we are fetching the instruction. So if this is a return instruction, we need to use the return address stack before we even determine that it is a return instruction. We cannot just keep pushing and popping things from the return address stack before we know it's a return. Because, for example, if there is an add and we pop from the return address stack, then it's not going to work correctly. We actually need to figure out, or at least very accurately predict, what's a return instruction so that we can use the RAS appropriately. So the problem is that we are using the RAT while fetching the instruction. It's not been decoded yet, so we don't know it's a return instruction yet. So how do we do it? One way is to just use a very simple predictor that will be trained on whether the instruction we are fetching is a RET or not. Simply train the predictor one way or the other depending on whether it's a RET or not, and then make that predictor tell us whether to use the return address stack or not. This would be a very accurate predictor. If at a particular PC we have seen a RET instruction previously, then it is very likely that if we see the same PC, we still have a return instruction. So we can use a single bit predictor very easily here. Another approach is to use a so-called pre-decoding. We will soon see that the processor really contains a cache that stores instructions that have been fetched from memory, and it's fetching instructions from the cache, and only if the cache doesn't already contain the instruction, it goes through memory. So the pre-decoding works by, when I'm fetching from memory, I decode enough of the instruction to know that it's a return or not, and I store that information along with the actual instruction in the cache. So pretty much my memory will, for example, have 32-bit instructions. In my cache, I will store 33 bits per instruction, 32 bits of the actual instruction, and one bit that tells me whether the instruction is a return or not. So the idea is that as the instruction is coming from memory and we put it to cache, we can be pre-decoding instructions, keeping some additional bits in the cache about the pre-decoding of the instruction so that when we fetch, we already know that information. The alternative to this would have been to just fetch the instructions from memory to cache as they are, and then every time we fetch, we have to figure out what this instruction is. Because it's also more power efficient to do this once and then fetch the instruction many times, rather than redo it every single time, pre-decoding is a very popular approach. So pre-decoding is used for things like, is it a return instruction? Is it a branch instruction at all? If we know it's not a branch, then we can completely omit the use of any branch predictors, thus saving a lot of power. If our instructions are of variable sizes, pre-decoding can also tell us, for example, how many bytes this instruction is long, so that we can fetch the next instruction quickly and not rely on just decoding the instruction before we can fetch the next one, and so on. So there is a lot of things that modern processors do in this pre-decoding phase in order to avoid doing it when we are on the clock after we have fetched the instruction.